A quick heads up before the video starts. With everything that's gone on in the world, from Black Lives Matter to the humanitarian crisis in Yemen, I understand it's a very scary time for everyone. In the description, you will find links to petitions you can sign and donations you can make to make a difference and help out, because everyone needs to do their part if we want to try and make the world a better place. If you need something to lift your spirits and take your mind off, enjoy the video. So, anyone who knows me in real life, or follows me on Letterboxd, shameless plug by the way, knows I have a certain soft spot for the coming of age genre, one that either seems to be adored or despised. And yeah, it's a genre of such a wide range of quality. For every Boyhood or Skate Kitchen, there's another 5 Noah Centineo movies. I think there's something really special about it. How it defines a generation culturally. The fears and anxieties, but also the attitude as well. The experience of that time. The film in which I think this is most evident, and has a lot of meaning to me, is Olivia Wilde's debut film. Booksmart is many things. It's one of my favourite comedies. It, while exaggerated in many ways, I think gives a sense of reality to the teenage experience, and doesn't glamorise it to the point of it being indistinguishable from a Tumblr edit. The situations may not feel entirely real, but the emotion certainly is. However, this way of telling the story, along with the general premise of the film, that being our teenage protagonists trying to get to a party on the last day of school, has led to many comparisons to a certain other coming-of-age film, that being Now it's clear they share a lot of similarities, but comparing them I think does a disservice to both films, as while they tackle very similar ideas and themes, they do it from very different perspectives, which are both entirely valid, but also because, if anything, both feel like homages to another film that I think really shaped modern coming of age, and I see as kind of a gold standard when it comes to high school films. That being Richard Linklater's Dazed and Confused. Alright. Bear with me on this one. Dazed is an interesting film to look at, as the early 90s marked a definite change for the coming of age genre. As a decade prior, John Hughes practically ruled the world with power pop anthems, Molly Ringwald, and casual sexual harassment. Okay then. The 80s absolutely shaped our expectations for the genre through these classics. Teenage angst on screen had never been this cool or exciting, with the exception of maybe Rival Without a Cause, and potentially The Graduate, although that's a film that definitely deserves its own video. People ate this shit up, and it's understandable why. Young people were finally starting to be heard, and under the strictly conservative and traditionalist Reagan administration, they needed a way to rebel, a fantasy to believe in, and these films gave them that escape. However, therein lies the problem. These films were, for the most part, escapist fantasies, romanticizing the teenage experience for a generation that grew up to realize this wasn't true, and this fantasy still runs through today. Now, don't get me wrong, I still love these movies, but that dream couldn't continue forever, Okay, so now back to Dazed. Richard Linklater is interesting in the way that he lives for authenticity, in the way he depicts relationships and growing up. In an interview, he stated, "It was really rare when star-crossed lovers from the opposite side of the tracks, and the girl gets pregnant, and there's a car crash and somebody dies. That didn't really happen much. But riding around, trying to look for something to do, if the music cranked up, now that happened a lot." To Linklater, it wasn't about this fantasy, but portraying adolescence as how it was. He wasn't afraid to show that teenagers are actually kind of a mess. They're loud, obnoxious, yet they have shit to say. They just don't know how to say it. He was honest, which led to a sort of deconstruction period through the 90s and into the 2000s. Films like Clueless and Mean Girls, and then later on with Easy A at the turn of the 2010s, were loving satires of the fantasy, yet at their core they still had earnest stories to tell. Linklater's honesty and rejection of the fantasy was felt and still holds true today. It defined a new generation to grow up understanding this. So where does this leave Booksmart then? A film so rooted in its Gen Z culture. Well, that's interesting. For a film so reliant on its current culture, there's still something so universal about it. It retains the honest depiction of adolescent emotion and struggle that has persisted for nearly 30 years. But there's something else, a theme at the core of this film that struck at the point I needed it most. A key feature that will remain timeless. The importance and love of friendship. Now, I know friendship seems like an obvious theme. It's something covered in most films. We all know the shtick. But for me, it was something deeper. Less the power of friendship solves everything, but more so the love you have for them. How they've shaped your life, and what lessons you take in moving on from them. To echo this point, we're gonna get into my personal experience with the film. So, story time, I guess. It was probably around this time last year. Maybe slightly earlier, I don't know. I just got out of a relationship after a not so perfect experience of being completely shut out and ignored. I hold no resentment to this person, but at the time, yeah, it was a tough blow. I felt alone, disregarded, and, well, just generally quite shitty. I spent a good few hours wallowing, but there was something telling me to cut that shit out and actively try to feel better. So, I decided to call up my best friend, who I knew was also having kind of a shitty day. And we decided that night to go out and see a film to try and make us feel better. Two tickets to Booksmart later and, well, there was a lot I felt. Not only did I just genuinely feel happier due to the humour and fun of the film, but there was something more to it. Seeing this story, unlike other coming-of-age friendship stories following similar tropes, was incredibly eye-opening. These two people who genuinely cared and who would do anything for each other, the inseparableness of them, and how they grow, and by the end, are ready to begin new stages of their lives, knowing their experience has shaped them into who they are, and they could never replace that bond. It made me appreciate all that I did have in my life, the people I hold dearest, my friends who I love wholeheartedly, the times we spent together, those endless days and nights just fucking around, just growing closer. I learned never to take that for granted. Say what you will about this film and this genre, you're allowed to have your opinions, but it doesn't take away from the fact they capture such an important part of our lives, an experience we all know, people we all cherish. The coming-of-age genre is important to our culture as it teaches us the value of these moments, allows us to reflect on our culture through a perspective we all relate to, and allows us to reminisce about a better time, to see how you've grown, or what you're still yet to learn. So this is my first video essay. Let me know what you thought of it, and if you want to see more, what topics do you want to see covered? And let me know what your favourite coming-of-age films are, and why. In the description, as mentioned in the opening, there will be links to petitions you can sign and donations to make, because it's such an important time right now. But that's everything. I have future projects lined up, so stay tuned for that. And I'll see you guys later.